Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can create a wormhole effect in After Effects and Element 3D. The effect we're going for is something like this. Now we're only going to be focusing on the wormhole effect in this video, but if that sounds interesting, let's get started. In my project window, I have two textures loaded. I have a cloudy texture that I made into a tileable image in Photoshop and just cleaned up some of the grain. This will look really cool in the wormhole. And I also have a really large star background. All right, let me close this footage tab and let's make a new composition. For this, I'm just gonna use full HD, 30 FPS, and then 300 frames. Now for this tutorial, I'm only gonna show the main wormhole effect, not the planet at the end and the text. Otherwise, this video would just go on forever. There's other resources that you can use for that. My wormhole also might look a little different to the one that I showed you since I did that several years ago, but I'll show you how to open it up and how you can get the whole thing in motion. Right, so the first thing that we want to do is grab that star background, pull it in, and this is a really, really large image, so we have quite a lot of room to play with. I'm just going to reposition this so I don't see any of those really large stars. Then I'm going to convert this into a 3D layer, and then on position, keyframe the position at 0, we'll go to around frame 100 or so, and then we'll just pull that towards us, and then I'll ease that in with the F9 key. Next, we're going to make a new solid. It's going to be for our wormhole element 3D. Then we're going to grab an element 3D effect. We need to go into custom layers, custom texture maps, and we actually need to load in textures here. I always recommend if you're using element 3D to load in your texture maps as custom texture map layers. That way, if you back up your After Effects project going into file dependencies, collect files, it will know to find those. If you do this all internally within element 3D, and then you move your computer or you switch folders or whatever, it will not find those files most of the time. So it's always a good idea to have them referenced. And then referencing them also allows you to swap them out on the fly and also just make adjustments to them as well. So I'm going to be using both of these. So I'll take copies of both of these down and I'll call this one wormhole cloud texture and then wormhole stars. Then both of these layers can be turned off for right now. Go back into the element layer. Layer one can be the wormhole cloud texture. Always do effects and masks. Layer two will be the wormhole stars, again, effects and masks. All right, so now let's enter the scene setup. The first thing that we want to do here is create a new tube. So we'll be using tubes and cylinders here, but for right now, we're just going to start off with a tube. I'll rotate this, scale it up, and then the internal radius, we'll set that to 99%. Now, if you're working on a computer that can handle Element 3D pretty well, you might want to change your sides, because we don't want to see faceting around the edges. While you're just working on it though, if you do run into an issue, this really shouldn't make too much of a difference, but you can always change these later before you start rendering. Next, what we want to do is open up the tube model and go into default, and then open up the texture set for illumination, and then we're going to set the cloud texture to be our first one. We're going to turn off the diffuse, set that to 0, set glossiness to 0, specular to 0, and then the environment to 0 as well. Then go down to illumination and increase the intensity to 100%. Next thing we need to do is tile this, so let's go up into our cylinder, and because this is going to be stretched out quite a bit, we do want to tile it quite a lot. So we'll do something like 4 around the perimeter of it and then 8 lengthwise. So this will do for our main cloud texture. I'll just call this clouds. Then I'm going to go in and make a cylinder. I'm going to do essentially the same thing. I'm going to make this very slightly smaller. Again, I'm going to increase the sides. Then we're going to scroll down to the surface options and invert the normals. So this is going to allow us to see in, but we're not going to be able to see it on the outside. You could do the same thing for the clouds, but for what I'm going to show you, this is going to allow us a little bit more control. But this is going to be slightly easier because I don't really want that cloud texture on the back. Let's go into our cylinder model, and this is going to be our stars. So on default, we're going to do the same thing that we did previously, set the diffuse to 0, along with the glossiness, specular, and environment multipliers. And on the illumination texture, we're going to grab in the stars background. Click OK. Then scroll down to illumination and set that equal to 100%. Now for this, we can't really see the stars on the texture here. I'm going to scale this down just a little bit more. We want the stars to be on top of the clouds, more like this. So these will get stretched out a little bit, but it's going to look pretty cool. We are going to go to that material though, scroll down to the bottom, and then we are going to change the blending mode to add. You could also use screen there, that would be fine. And then now we're ready for the last part. We're going to take a copy of the stars, duplicate that with Control D, move this over. Now we need to be careful because these two materials are actually the same one. We're going to right click over that one and do duplicate and replace. And this entire piece of the geometry is just going to be the cap. So basically the portal that you're looking through. Go to the blending mode, set that back to normal. Remove that texture, and then I'm going to remove the illumination as well. We're just going to have this black for right now, and we'll close that up. and put it right at the end. So now we get the stars background adding on top of it, but at the end you can change this, add something else in it. All right, click OK. For this next part, we're going to grab an adjustment layer. This is going to be for our bulge. So in order to make it look like this tunnel is like warping space-time, we're going to grab a bulge effect. And bulge is going to start off with a radius of 0 for their horizontal and vertical radius. And we'll go forward to around frame 60 and keyframe both of these. And then we'll go forward to frame 90. And we'll set these up to about 1200. You want this to completely encompass the canvas. So if you're working at like 4K or something, you'll need to increase this. And turn off the element effect so we can see what that is doing. So it's warping from the center outward. That's giving this kind of like a cool 3D look. We taper the radius in like 400 and tidy up the edges, make them look a little bit more interesting. All right, so that's basically how we're gonna do the bulge. Now on the bulge though, we are gonna wanna get rid of this bulge because it will affect every layer underneath and it's quite an intensive effect. So we wanna get rid of it as soon as we can. To do that, what we're gonna do is just gradually fade this off from frame 90. So click Shift T to bring up opacity. We'll set the opacity to 100 and then we'll go forward to around frame 160 and we'll set that to 0. Okay, so I'm gonna take my wormhole, turn this on. And this looks like garbage right now, but don't worry about it. We'll fix that in a moment. I just want to get the overall transition down. So at around frame 80, we're going to start this. And what we need to do is open up the group one folder, open up particle look. And we have several things to animate here. So we're going to start with particle size XYZ, and we're going to be changing the Z size. We also want to open up particle rotation and keyframe the Z rotation. Next, we're going to go down to world transform and keyframe world position Z. And the very last thing is going to be opacity, and we'll keyframe that at 0 to begin with. So with opacity, we'll go forward to a frame 100, set the opacity to 100%, so it's just going to do a simple fade throughout those keyframes, then we'll go back to frame 80. Z size is going to start off at 0, and then for world position Z, what we're going to do is just set that to like negative 1500, so it's going to start a lot closer. More like that. And then with the particle rotation, what we're going to do, we'll bring this keyframe up to about frame 90. Then at frame 160, we'll take the Z size up to 100. That's basically what's stretching it out. You can see we're just making that extend into the background. World position Z, we can go to around frame 270-ish towards the end. Just let that go half a rotation, so 180 degrees. And then at frame 270, we'll take world position Z and we'll just pull this up until we have cleared the end of the cylinder. Basically right there. All right, so let's take a look at what we have so far. Got the wormhole punching out and then we start speeding up. Now this transition in the middle where the bulge is ending and then everything else begins to really pick up, I just want to ease those in, so just select them, F9. So that's for the bulge opacity and the wormhole Z size. And that's a pretty smooth transition. Okay, so right now this looks pretty garbage in terms of the color and lighting, but we've got everything else kind of working together. So one more thing to just to help with the transition, I don't want to be able to see this fully at the beginning, so I'm just going to use a simple Luma mat to fade that in. Let's go ahead and add a new solid above the wormhole, call this wormhole mat, and then for this we'll just grab a fractal noise effect. Change the type to turbulent smooth, going to give us a nicer looking effect there. And all of that we're going to do on frame 80, we're going to set the brightness down until this is black, and then we'll go forward until around frame, let's say 100, and then we'll change this so everything is white. So go into the transform, I'm going to scale that up by double. Also be cool to have some evolution. Just add in a time expression there, so it's kind of going to be moving around time times 1000. Turn this mat off, and on the wormhole element 3D layer, the track mat will be set to Luma. I'll pull these out just a few more frames there, just increase the length of that transition a little bit. Something more like that. It looks a little bit blocky for right now, but with motion blur on, I think it's going to look a little bit better. And then the next thing is we can also add some radial fast blur to this. For that, we'll go ahead and add a new adjustment layer, radial fast blur. Drag this over. And then starting at frame 90, we'll take the amount down to 0, keyframe that. Then go to 160, and then we'll crank up the amount to 50%. Now let's go and play around with the color, because right now this looks pretty dreadful. First thing that we can do, both of these, since they are referenced, we can either pre-compose these or we can just leave them as is. So if you wanted to combine textures, for example, you would pre-compose these and put other textures in, and they would apply to the element material. But for right now, what we want to do is just grab a curves, and just so we can see this, I'll solo this, and then we can go ahead and just crush down these values. All right, take a look at what that has done. That looks better for the texture, but the stars are overpowering. So this is the stars one. I'm not going to turn that layer on, and I'm just going to crush this down. So since this is being referenced, it's going to apply inside. And I'm actually going to crush this quite a lot. I really don't want any of that cloudiness to come through. Grab a hue and saturation, and I will actually knock down the saturation quite a bit. Maybe something around negative 60-ish. Let's go back to the cloud texture, do another curves here. I really want to crush that down quite a bit, so I'll put it in like a supporting point here so that doesn't get completely clipped. Then just to add a little bit more brightness contrast, I'm going to grab a brightness contrast effect. I'm going to bump up the contrast and then really crank the brightness up. I'm going to give this just a little bit more of those brights back in. All right, so we have something kind of like that. I think I am going to go back into that Z rotation, just ease that in on that first keyframe. It's going to help a little bit. All right, so some other things that we can do just to add a little bit more interest into this shot before we go on. We can add some more particles. So for this, we can grab a new solid, call this particles. We're looking for a CC particle world effect. So on this, these wouldn't actually start till around frame 160. And we're gonna need to open up particles, physics, and then we can have the birth rate. At the beginning, birth rate would be at zero. We could go forward till around frame 250-ish. And then we could increase the birth rate to something like 0.1. We really don't want that many particles. Click U to display the keyframes. I'll pull this up a little bit, maybe T30. And then by frame 260 or so, we can just stop all particles from emitting. We want to make sure the gravity is at zero and the velocity can be set to 2, but we will keyframe that. So we could do something like at around frame 250, these begin to slow down. And then by towards the end here, these will stop at 0.5. Longevity, we'll set that to 10 as well, so these can last a bit longer. For the death color, we'll just make that black. And then for the birth color, we'll set that to white. Volume shade, I always like to do 100%, just give some more variation. We will be using motion blur, so that will add some streaks to it later. And that's probably all we really need to do there. So if I solo just these particles, these won't really show up until everything's at in full motion like it is at around frame 160. And then we'll get some extra particles coming in here. And as soon as we leave the wormhole, then they'll all just kind of slow down. I'm gonna add a little bit of glow to this. I really like real glow. It's no longer supported, but I think the vanilla glow for After Effects would suffice for this. I'm going to drop down the opacity of the entire layer to 50%. Then I'll just blend in a little bit better. All right, now let's work on this ending cap. For this, I'm going to use this smoke sprite texture. I'll just put that on the Element 3D object. So let's take this file down, turn it off, go back into Element 3D, go to Custom Texture Maps, and then we're going to load in layer 3 as that smoke sprite, and then enter the scene setup. So right now the cap is just black, but let's go into the illumination, set that to custom layer 3, scroll down, increase the intensity to 100, go to the cap, go down to UV mapping. We can lower the UV repetitions and then just reposition the offset wherever we'd like. And then we can see that on here. You can go to the spoke sprite texture, grab a curves, make that blend in a little bit better. Now for this next part, we're gonna make a new solid, call this tunnel cap matte, and set the width and height to a 2K resolution. I'm going to pre-compose that, leave all attributes, lock the current comp, double-click the new comp, drag this over, and then we can work inside here. I'm going to take an ellipse tool, double-click it, grab a fill effect, and just make this white. I'm going to knock this down just a little bit. Duplicate the mask. On the second mask, we'll set that to subtract. At frame 160, set a mask expansion keyframe, and then by the end, we'll close this up. So something pretty simple. Now for this, what we're gonna do is actually duplicate our wormhole element 3D, so control D. This one is not gonna use a track mat though. Go into custom layers, custom texture maps, layer 4, we'll just say that is gonna be our tunnel cap map, and enter the scene setup. I'm gonna hide the stars and clouds texture, and on the cap, we're gonna replace the texture in illumination with custom layer 4. I am going to reset the UVs though. And if we solo this layer, you can now see how that mask is going to be used. So that ring is going to get larger and larger and larger until we nearly reach the end. If you want to close this up, you can just pull this keyframe in and that will affect the Element 3D surface as well. Next, what we're going to do is combine the wormhole mat with the tunnel cap mat to pre-compose these. I'll just call this Element 3D combined mat. then we need to go inside that comp. You'll notice that it's pulled in other referenced layers as well. But for this, all we need is to have both of these on. On this top layer, we're going to add a simple choker to get rid of that black edge. I'm just going to choke that in until that edge goes away and go back to our main comp. Now we don't need this layer to be on. We can turn that off. And now we can see there's a hole in the center. We can go back to the tunnel cap mat, add a roughen edges effect so we can make the border not as perfectly smooth. So the next thing we want another copy of this Element 3D layer. This is going to be a glow mat. I always try to avoid having multiple duplicates of Element 3D scenes since they're not really interactive, but all I want to do here is turn off the stars and the clouds. And on this cap here, custom layer 3, we'll remove that and then everything will just be white. Click OK and turn off the Luma track mat. So we can use this as a mat for a glow effect. Let's solo this. Because a glow effect would need to be allowed to exceed this radius. I'm going to blur this slightly. Underneath this effect, call this glow. Glow can use the above layer as a track mat, unsolo it. I'm going to use a real glow effect. You guys will probably just have to use a regular glow, but this gives better results. I'm going to enable tint. I'm going to just select this type of color and then just boost the brightness. Drop back the radius and increase the intensity. Probably want to leave this on screen. These values can be clamped, they will not clip, so adding it will definitely give you some clipped areas. Screen will not, so depending on how much brightness you want, might be a better idea. Then we can refine the mat with our curves, something like that. So that's one idea. It's not exactly what I used for my version. Mine was overly complicated, but that's a pretty simple way to do it. On this glow effect, what we're going to do is just start animating this around frame 160. Set a keyframe for opacity at 0. And then we'll go forward until 200, like that. So the last thing we're going to do is add some camera shake. This is going to add just a little bit more life into the shot. If you haven't seen my previous videos on camera shake, we're going to be using the same techniques, which involves adding a null object, adding slider controls, and attaching the sliders to a wiggle effect. I'm not going to go over that again because I've done it in several tutorials, but if you would like to check that video out, just click on the card and that should take you there. After adding in the camera shake, there's a couple more things that we could do to improve the background a little bit. Grab a curves and just darken down the curves a bit. We'll clear out some of the stars. And then just to improve this transition a little bit, this transition here works pretty well. But you can see at the edges, the background stops as the wormhole opens up. So what we can do that's really simple to fix, simply select the keyframes for the bulge and just pull these out a little bit. And then they won't stop. Then on the main Element 3D layer, I'm gonna grab a curves. I'm gonna darken this down just a little bit, pull this up. Grab a red channel, pull down the shadows in the red a little bit. Just make that go a little bit more bluish. Then we can go back up to the glow and change this real glow to be tinted a little bit more blue, just so it matches a little bit better. And at the very end, don't forget to add motion blur. And like with most of the projects that we do on this channel, you could play around with it forever, but this gives you the basic idea of how to achieve this effect. All right, so here's the final result for this version. And the version that I had done previously looked like this. Very similar techniques were involved. I tried to do almost the same thing. I couldn't remember exactly on certain things, but, and then of course we had that secondary scene. All right guys, thank you so much for watching. Hope you learned something. If you did, drop a like. If you have any questions, post a comment. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Peace.